Hello and welcome to video lecture series in Sociology. Today we are going to discuss chapter 6 titled as Globalization and Social Change from your textbook Social Change and Development in India. We have already started discussing this chapter in which we have discussed about concept of globalization, how globalization affects our lives, taking example from Indian society. We have discussed about economic aspects of globalization, global communications and international division of labor. In the previous part of this chapter, we had discussed about political dimension of globalization, global governance and about global civil society and international organizations. In this lecture, we will discuss about social and cultural dimensions of globalization in detail. There are many ways in which globalization affects our daily lives and culture. Globalization influences what we eat, what we drink, what we wear, what we watch, how we behave or how we express ourselves, what we think, our choices, lifestyles and preferences. Cultural globalization is an important dimension because many sociologists argue that globalization among all is a cultural phenomena because it involves rapid interaction and intense interaction of different cultures from all across the globe. The globalization of culture entails emergence of global consumer culture. Goods and cultural products such as music, dance, cinema has got spread all over the world through satellite and cable television. This has resulted in wider and deeper cultural exchanges at international or global level. We can see a complex web of social relationships and cultural connections happening across globe. According to Anthony Giddens, in the modern era, the level of time-space distanciation is much higher than any previous era, and the relations between local and distant social forms and events become correspondingly stretched. Globalization refers essentially to that stretching process. Insofar as the modes of connection between different social contexts or regions become networked across the Earth's surface as a whole. Globalization can thus be defined as the intensification of worldwide social relations, which link distant localities in such a way that local happenings are shaped by events occurring many miles away, and vice versa. Those who see culture at the center of globalization see emergence of global culture as an important consequence of process of globalization, because globalization is understood as a process that is influencing social and cultural fabric of various societies world over. Emerging global culture is seen as both a cause and a consequence of process of convergence. The various aspects of culture that have been very distinct and different from one another are more and more becoming similar to each other. These aspects are shopping experiences, media visuals, entertainment programs, fast food, dress and clothing styles. You might be knowing that many cities have become global cities. These global cities share similar features in terms of infrastructure, facilities, lifestyles, housing patterns, malls, nature of roads, etc. Decades back, many years back, Marshall McLuhan had used the term global village. The term global village does not mean that the world is becoming smaller, but it also means that the world is also becoming similar. With advancement of technology, media, internet, social working sites, distance no longer matters now. We share our experiences with people located in distant parts of the world in the same manner as with those who live close to us. Say for example, the moment you upload images or photographs of any celebration, these pictures can be exist in any corner of the world by people whom you know and also by whom you do not know. When cultural homogenization is an important aspect of globalization, the process also generates precisely the opposite effect also. The fear is that the process of globalization poses a threat to other cultures in the world. A central contention or a problem is that all cultures will eventually become similar, that is, homogeneous in nature. Because it is thought, globalization leads to a rise of uniform culture. This is also called as cultural homogenization. Some scholars argue that the rise in a uniform culture is not an emergence of global culture. What we have in the name of global culture is the imposition of the Western culture, particularly European and American, on the rest of the world. The culture of the politically and economically dominant nation is being imposed upon less developed and developing nations. For example, George Ritzer uses the concept of McDonaldization of the world. Among many aspects of this concept, one meaning is that Cultures are seeking to follow the dominant American style of life. This is dangerous not only for the less developed countries, but for the humanity in general, as it leads to shrinking of rich cultural heritage of the small and distinct cultures all over the globe. There are many scholars who argue that there is an increasing tendency towards globalization of culture. Globalization refers to the mixing of global with the local. The concept of glocal comes from combination of two words, global plus local, which is equal to glocal. Globalization refers to the dynamics of process of globalization, where one can see process of homogenization and heterogenization occurring at the same time and in the same space, which means a combination of global practices with the local practices, which is leading to the glocal practices coming into existence. An example of globalization can be seen in many fast food chains selling only vegetarian products in India during festival times, say Navratri. In the field of music, one can see the growing popularity of Bhangra pop or Indie pop, fusion music and even remixes. The process of mixing of global with local leads to each culture becoming more different, rich and distinctive in nature. Sometimes external influences reduce our choices, but they also add variety to the existing choices and they also modify or add to the culture without crushing the traditional. For example, you can say burger is no substitute for a samosa. It is simply an addition to the choices available to us. Our blue jeans goes well with a khadi kurta. These influences in fact add richness and variety to the culture rather than pose a threat or a challenge to the already existing traditional practices. This phenomena is called as cultural heterogenization. This is not to deny that there is no difference in power when cultures interact. But cultural exchanges are rarely one way. They affect both the cultures, the recipient and the dominant culture. You know that the social reformers in 20th century attempted to embrace modernity with tradition. Here, tradition was influenced by the modern ideas. But the strength of the Indian culture has always been its flexibility, assimilation and open nature. Although India was always open to cultural influences, but the given scale and intensity of change, there is a debate about changes brought about by globalization in India. Some sociologists argue that the process of globalization is leading to erosion of local cultures in India. They are leading to a decline in the traditional practices and traditions. The local language, rituals, symbols, dressing patterns no longer attract people, particularly the younger generation. The young ones are increasingly being fascinated by global cultural practices originating from the West, which includes the food, the lifestyle, and the media, what they watch regularly. But you should remember that cultures are not static. They keep on changing, and external influences are one of the most important factors that brings about changes in culture. What is more likely even today is that globalization will lead to creation of not just new local tradition, but global ones as well. Along with this fusion, globalization has also unleashed culture of consumption. Let us discuss the culture of consumption in a bit detail. Culture of consumption is playing an important role in the process of globalization, especially in shaping the growth of cities. Till the 1970s and 80s, the manufacturing industries used to play a major role in the growth of cities. Cities were mainly industrial centers and they offered many essential facilities and avenues for recreation. Now, with culture of consumption coming into existence, the culture industry shapes to a large extent the growth of cities. Try to figure out the development in your city and how much of this is a case of cultural globalization. The cultural globalization is evident in the spurt of growth of shopping malls, multiplex cinema halls, amusement parks, water parks, and in every major city, these kind of developments are happening. This pattern has led to rise in culture of consumption of the goods that are now available world over. Try to imagine the difference between a traditional shop in a local market and a departmental store in a shopping mall. What kind of difference do you perceive? In a shop, you ask for the things that you intend to buy for use. On the contrary, in a departmental store, you go around and pick up the things that you wish to buy. The interesting part is that the moment you hold a thing in your hand, you feel like buying it. So you end up buying even those things which may not be of immediate or necessary use to you. trolley shopping, that is shopping in a trolley where you pick up goods from the shelf and keep them in the trolley, is an important marketing strategy to connect buyer to the product instantaneously and increase the sales. If we compare a shopping mall to a traditional market or a shop in a market, we'll see the meaning of shopping has changed over the years. With entry of multinational corporations, people have more options to choose from. Even the style of shopping has changed. It has become a recreational activity that people plan shopping on weekends and go with the family to do shopping. There are different brands of clothes, accessories, shoes, cosmetics, electronic and electrical items, cars, cuisines, means of entertainment such as bowling alley, amusement parks, etc. Along with these dimensions of globalization, let us also discuss about resistance to process of globalization. This resistance is also called as anti-globalization movement. The anti-globalization movement highlights the damage done and inequalities generated by the process of globalization, particularly the economic globalization. It comprises of groups and people from different functional areas, those who argue that globalization needs to be challenged, and it has accelerated and strengthened the dominance of hegemony of the Western powers, particularly US and the European society. It is important to remember that modern development, even prior to stages of globalization, did make inroads into traditional culture forms and occupations. But the intensity and scale of change in the era of globalization is immense that it cannot be ignored. That is why, to large extent, people blame that globalization creates imbalances and inequalities. Some scholars argue that because of process and forces of globalization, the traditional forms of art, culture, means of entertainment such as theater, natak, what you call as popularly nukkad natak or nautanki, they have become obsolete or are not enjoyed by people as compared to modern Western forms of entertainment. Not just the cultural or traditional practices, in fact, globalization has negatively influenced many economic, political and social practices that were source of livelihood for many people. Various forms of indigenous and traditional knowledge in the field of medicine such as Ayurveda or yoga and Vastu are being packaged and sold in different forms to the consumers from the West. You must have also heard that recently some multinational companies attempted to patent the use of tulsi, neem, haldi, basmati rice and rudraksh. There is an urgent need to protect our indigenous knowledge systems against these kind of Western forces. To conclude, let us try to briefly understand what are the main features of globalization. As with any other process of change that we have studied so far in this book, like modernization, westernization, Sanskritization, secularization, urbanization, industrialization, globalization is also a process of social change, but it is all encompassing. You may simply call it as a process of deterritorialization, where boundaries between nations do not matter. Specifically, the process of globalization comprises of, number one, from economic dimension, internationalization of trade and investment, that is internationalization of economy. Second, from political perspective, liberalization and policies opening up of economies and markets to the global forces. Point number three, from social and cultural perspectives, globalization entails universalization and homogenization, which means cultural exchange and emergence of global culture. Finally, it means glocalization, a combination of global and local, and Western domination, as argued by some scholars, that is, the domination of Western cultural practices and values. To conclude, let us summarize this chapter. In this chapter, we have attempted to learn about the process of globalization, how globalization has affected social change, and how it has influenced our lives. We have analyzed the impact of globalization on economy, politics, society, culture, organizations, work, environment, and lifestyles. Different perspectives on globalization, namely hyperglobalist, transformationalist, and the skeptics. In this chapter, we also discussed about the aspect of anti-global movements, that is, the movements which are opposing the process of globalization. It is not easy to sum up such a vast topic like globalization in few words or pages. It will be interesting for you to experience and explore process of globalization yourself. Till we meet next, enjoy reading this chapter.